Hello, and welcome back to Technical Tales Galactic Science. This is my second attempt at this episode. Reason being that just as I was doing the last one... Oops, well, I was trying to reveal that as a surprise, but I don't know how F5 works. There it is. Anyway, about 3 minutes into doing the last one, it turned out that my sorting chest had stopped sorting. And I couldn't get it to start again, and it was really, really annoying. So I spent like 20 minutes on camera trying to fix it, but I've decided to just abandon that. Basically, I've got a new chest here. I had to write this out all again. I've now got this typed out into a text file in case I need it again. But we've got expanded storage space. So once again, this is a sorting chest with sorting barrels, and to get it to go around the corners, there's this little item called a sorting connector. Relatively easy and cheap to make. And that lets the barrels wrap around the room. So as you can see, I've got a lot more space. I think I'm going to have them stop here. I don't want them to come further over, but I've got, you know, I can reach... If necessary, I can reach that far up the wall. So, plenty of room. The only other thing I've done is added a sag mill here. It's getting fed flint from the system. Just got flint in there. And then iron ore, copper ore, and tin ore. Now, these aren't the crushed sandy stuff. This is basically the stuff that's coming out of there. And when it grinds them up, I double the amount of ore I get. And there's a percentage chance of getting bonus ore. Like, for every bit of copper I get, there's like a 10% chance or something to get gold. Having the flint increases sag mill output, grinding ball, main output 120%, bonus output 125%, and a power reduction. You can put something even better than that in there. But I've got tons of flint. That's nice and easy. This thing, I think those are the same, yep. The electric furnace has been set now to do the powder, because powder is what the sag mill outputs. That's all I've done on that, and then I expanded my storage. Oh, and added a couple of extra oxygen sealers in order to make this extra space. So what are we doing today? Today, I think we've got to push power. Because I was looking at the book and also watching another Let's Player, Retac. R-E-A-T-A-C. He's pretty good. And so I've sort of seen a little bit of what's involved in the fusion and stuff. Using fusion and fission, you can convert one element into another element. And so basically, I can make the Einsteinium I need for enderpearls in a fusion reactor. Presumably also you can make the stuff you need for nether stars and everything else. But it requires a ton of power. Now, these things are doing pretty well. And they can be upgraded. Double layer capacities gives 2.7 efficiency. Now, that increases burn rate. I don't know whether or not it increases the RF per tick. What's needed for a double layer capacitor? Double layer capacitor. Crushed coal, easy. Energetic alloys. Redstone, glowstone, gold in an alloy smelter. That's easy enough. And those are easy enough. All right, let me whip up some of those. Now, I do have... Where is it? My alloy smelter. And my plan is that for things like this, machines I use for processing and building, things like the circuit fabricator, I'm probably going to make an electric compressor, and so on. I want them in here, in the other half of the room. The idea being that, you know, this is my crafting room. You know, this is where I've got all my item storage. It's where I've got the machines to process stuff. I can have crafting tables. and so on. So I'm going to need to run some power, just some electric cable. I can probably just tap it off from there under the ground, bring it up, probably on both sides. I could run the power on the ground, but I have found it's useful because I might want to temporarily wire my crafting machines together using pipes of various types. Nope, doesn't matter. I'll work it out, and I'll be back once there's some basic power, and I've moved the other crafting machines and stuff, and I've probably gotten together the materials I need for a couple of double capacity thingies. I think there is a quest to do with those. More power. Nope, that's something else. Yeah, so I don't think there's a quest specifically to do with them. So I'll get on and do that. And the sorting chest has stopped working again. Everything's just in here. It's really annoying. I hit sort, which is supposed to trigger, you know, it outputting stuff. I mean, there's no filters here, so everything should pass through. Now, I've just moved the filter from up there down to there. On the basis that whenever it's up there and you destroy the chest, it pops out and you lose all the data, so you've got to type it again. So I just moved it down there, retyped everything, and I'm hoping that breaking that chest will fix it. Let me just put stuff away that I don't want to end up in the sorting system. Okay. So let's break this chest. Everything flies everywhere. And I go looking for the chest. Where is it? Chest is down there. Right, let's put the chest back. And stuff isn't sorting. Look at that, just no sorting. What is up with these? Okay, I've got the flow of items turned off using this one-way pipe there. And I think I'm just going to have to leave it off. Okay, could you guys tell me, do you know why that keeps failing? And if you don't know why that keeps failing, I mean, everything should be fine here. There's Mars cobblestone. There is a barrel for Mars cobblestone. These are all sorting barrels going all the way to it. So, if you know what's wrong, please tell me. If you don't know what's wrong, is there a more reliable alternative? I mean, I've got this... it's not in there. It's over here. I've got this item router, which I think might... You know, if I replace that chest with this item router, would everything just fly to the right inventories? Or is it a lot more complex than that? If someone could please tell me or point me at an actual, you know, alternative storage systems. There's also this thing called modular storage systems, which appears to be you just make a whole load of modular storage underground, and then you've got like an interface block, and you can run searches and so on. And this seems quite nice. The only problem is that... What do you mean, recipe disabled, unstable block? Oh yeah, there's a bug with this that crashes the game. So those are out. I need an alternative. The only other thing I can think is that I forget the chest and I just run pipes behind every single barrel. And then the items will flow past and they'll find their barrel. And right at the end, I've got an overflow chest. But that is ugly. It's probably laggy. Please help me on this. Meanwhile, I'm going to carry on with the crafting and the power. Okay, I think I've got the materials for a couple of double layer, well, for a double layer capacitor. Boom, there we go. Might be worth mixing up a little more energetic alloy and getting a second one. But let's actually just test this. If I stick this in a machine, in one of these Stirling generators, what does it do for me? Like, is all this worth the effort? Okay, so currently generating 20 RF per tick with a burn rate of times 2. Okay, that doubles the energy rating. So it doubles the amount of power it makes and improves the burn time. Okay, it's worth making more. Can I've got glow 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, I got 3. So, put this into this thing's defaulted back to furnace mode. Alloys only. Okay. So furnace only, all smelting, alloys only. That way, you know, if you stick something in which can be burned on its own, it won't accidentally start burning it. So we'll put the 2 gold in and the 2 glowstone. We'll make another 2 energetic alloy and make one more of these things. Do I have enough crushed coal? Yep, coal powder, crushed coal, same stuff. Made that in the sag mill. I want to see, can you put more than one of these things in one thing? Now, one of the things I've done is I've put my level 3 crafter tier here because these Ender IO machines can be configured to push and pull in and out of nearby inventories. So if I want to, say, make all of these, I think if I just supply this with, I mean, you know, it can make its own basic capacitors, you know, if I tell it. And then once it's got a load of them, then, you know, basically the alloy smelter can be making the electric alloy, and when it finishes, it'll push it into here, which will then craft it for me. I've got some triple compressed cobblestone stuck in this machine. Anyway, 2. All right, there's one more. Can you add more than one? No. So it's a single one per machine. It's probably worth doing to improve the efficiency and the amount of energy these things output. But I will do that off camera, probably in between episodes. Just wanted to investigate that. So we are going to push this because this gives us things like gas turbines, which seem to be a good source of lots and lots of power. I mean, these things are, well, if I upgrade them, there'll be 40 per tick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 18 times 40 is a number, but it's not that high a number. The gas turbine I saw Retac make was putting out like 10,000 RF per tick or something, and that was having trouble coping with the fusion reactor. So, yeah. We're definitely going to push this line. So, fat is love. Maybe don't hurt me. You will need some more power, I guess. Start with making a vat, because vats are cool. Now, I'm not sure I'm going to use the vat, but it's definitely worth looking into. I thought there were broken spawners at first. Okay, so cauldron, easy enough. Machine chassis, basic capacitors. Needs dash. I've got some dash coming in. Electrical steel, again, it's just the alloy smelter. Iron, coal dust or coal powder, and silicon. More electrical steel and a furnace. That's easily enough done. Interesting. The raw silicon won't go in there to make the electric steel. So if we check on this, See, the coal is flicking through coal dust and coal powder. Whereas the silicon is just sat there on silicon. So it has to be Ender IO silicon. Okay, you can put clay in a sag mill, redstone, or sand through a sag mill. Okay, I'm using the sag mill over there. I really could do with another one over here. So I've got some sand, and I can always make more because I can now make sand by just running cobblestone through a sag mill. So this should get me silicon. Although it's only a percentage chance. You can see not everyone is giving me silicon. So I'm probably just going to let the rest of this run. There we go. That's making the electrical steel. Fluid tanks. I didn't actually look at this. So glass, iron bars, iron. Easy enough done. Just need basic capacitor. Okay, one vat. Now I know the vat does it require power? Don't know. Let's throw it down. Doesn't look like it. No, it does require power. So the idea of this is you can mix two different ingredients and it will make stuff like rocket fuel or oil or kerosene, any liquids, all sorts of stuff. So recipes, yeah. So that's rocket fuel, that's fire water, nutrient distillation, which is useful for there's something called a killer joe you can use in a mob spawner to kill mobs for you, and you have to feed it nutrient distillation, and hooch. But I don't think I'm actually going to need this, but we've made it because it's part of the quest and for the rewards, which is a world transfer node and a world interaction upgrade. And I get to choose sucrose, cellulose, that's just sugar and wood. So I am going to go for the reward bag at this stage. All right, so we will pop these away. I'm trying to sort of have a bag with me with pipes and wires and tools and upgrades and the sort of stuff I'm always needing. Could throw the vat in there, but I think I'll put it in here instead. A good reward bag. A load of dyes. Okay. Get a little bit of sugar. Right, what's next? Rocket fuel. Okay, well, we play in space, so rocket fuel fits the power scheme. I wonder if it will blow up the generators, though. One rocket fuel bucket. I think I got that from a quest reward ages ago. Now, it gets me 3 iron turbine rotors. This is the stuff the gas turbines use, although iron is the lowest tier of rotor. You can sort of upgrade them, I think. So, claim the middle one. It's a greater reward bag. Spawn Paul, again. Still not sure who Paul is or why I want to spawn him, but I've got 3 of them. Okay. Next. Advanced generator. Okay, advanced generator is a multi-block structure. What block you use defines how much energy it produces per tick, how much fluid it can hold, and so on. Okay, so this is the gas turbine controller. I'm probably going to have to look this up. Gets me a bottle of enchanting. Okay. Okay, so iron frames, easy enough. Iron tubing, easy. Redstone iron wire, easy. It's just this thing in the middle. Control circuit. 4 dash, nether quartz, redstone. Easy. Okay, so when you look at the gas turbine controller in NEI, it says there the possible modules it can have. Redstone control modules, up to 10. Power emitter module, up to 6. Fuel air mixer, 1. Sensor module, up to 10. Turbine, 1 to 50. And I think that's where you really expand your energy capacity. Power capacity up to 10, fluid intake valve up to 5, gas mix compressor 1, and fuel tanks up to 10. And then it's also sort of is listing all the stuff that can be used in it next to it. What's that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so it's all there. So maybe I don't have to look stuff up. I just stick stuff next to each other. I mean, it kind of makes sense that a fuel air mixture, power capacitors, power emitters, and stuff like that are necessary. Things like sensor modules and redstone control, probably optional. One gas turbine. Right. This thing's going to take up a lot of room, because you can see how many blocks it can take. Let's do the maths on this, shall we? I make that about 101 blocks if you stuck everything in. So a 10 by 10 room would probably be the way to go. Although that does mean you wouldn't be able to change stuff out that, you know, which was in the middle. So definitely going to expand this wall here, because this is where my power generation is. Right, let's take a look at the quest book and see what it suggests. Gets me a bottle of enchanting. Go with the first reward bag. What have we got? A good reward bag. More dyes. What's next? A choice. Okay, well, for a start, Ender Quarry. Already made one of those. Well, Minecraft, all fun and games until you get bored of digging out planets. That's why we developed this mining tool that makes giant dirt chunks for you. Yeah, so... Now I get the Ender Marker. When I made that Ender Quarry, I tried to make the Ender Marker. Because rather than using fence posts, you can use Ender Markers to indicate where it's supposed to dig. But when I was trying to make these, it needed the QED device, which needed more ender pearls to make it, and then it needed these emitters, which needed even more ender pearls to make it. So I gave up. That's because I made the ender quarry too early. If I'd have made it when I'm supposed to, okay. I've got 3 spawn pools, so claim reward. I'll stick the ender markers in my bag. Those are going to be very useful when it comes to moving the quarry. Right. A greater reward bag. Filled fuel canister. Not that great at this stage of the game. Actually, I'm going to put that in my bag. Because I'm trying to sort of build up also stuff I would need for other planets. I'm going to need another golden bag at some point. It's a shame you can't make them be different colours. Golden Bag of Holding Reincarnating 1. What is that? Because I've got magical wood. Quick Google search. Craft the bag with Reincarnation 1, allowing it to remain in the player's inventory and retain all its contents upon the player's death and respawn. This enchantment only works once. Ooh. Yes. Because then I can make sure that there's a spare quest book in there. I can make sure... Now, the only question is, can I do it without having to empty the contents? Right, there it is. One reincarnating golden bag of holding. It's got an oxygen mask, oxygen gear, and a number of tanks of oxygen. Also has a spare quest book. And it has... more magical wood. The only thing I think it really needs is a crafting table. The idea being that no matter where I am, I will be able to breathe, have the quest book, and remake the golden bag of holding, the reincarnating version of it, because it just requires 2 magical wood. Also, I tested it by leaving a stick of wood in there, and you can craft the bag of holding into a reincarnating bag of holding without losing the inventory. So, useful thing. What was I in the middle of doing? I was doing more power. I had just done this. Okay, now this is interesting. There is no enter space, so we had to get rid of tesseracts and create a nifty thing which uses dimensions instead. Dimensional transceiver, I believe, will let me send and receive power cross-dimensionally. As you can see, make one, get another for free. That way, rather than having that little power set up on Mars, I can actually just be transmitting power from my base here to the quarry on Mars, which means it will run a lot quicker. The recipe for this, electrical steel, that's fine. An octadic capacitor. Vibrant alloy. Uses ender pearls. Colored glowstone. Ender crystal. Needs a soul binder. With vibrant crystal, which requires ender pearls, and an ender resonator. Needs an enderman head. Not easy. And more vibrant alloy. So we won't be doing that yet. So we're dead-ended on that route through. With the heat exchanger, I can produce steam from lava. Okay, so steam is one way you can be powering your turbines. Oh, gets me some einsteinium, which obviously I can turn into enderpearls. I do have some of that stuff. Turbines. The more you add to your multi-block, the more RF output per tick you receive. And of course, the faster and faster the fuel will burn. You need at least one for it to work. So, iron turbine rotors. Iron ingot, iron turbine blades. Essentially, a lot of iron. Although you get four of those, you need eight. So, it's 11 iron per one of them. But it gets me a steel turbine upgrade kit. Which is essentially a way of turning, you know, but you may as well just make the steel turbines straight off the bat. Steel turbines, of course, is another 11. So what I'm doing is I'm going through these because I'm then going to have to do a lot of building off camera, I think. And we'll return at the end of the episode with some of this stuff done. So we can go steam. We can go syngas. An alternative to rocket fuel is to create syngas. Finally, another use for all that coal you have collected. Syngas producer controller. Seems a bit complex. The rewards aren't anything special. It's the same with the steam. What is this? Now, all that rocket fuel, maybe we should use it for something. Yeah, fluid intake valve. That's part of the turbine. Buffering, please. Fuel tank, in case you wanted to increase the internal tank storage of your turbine. And finally, steam usages. To use all that steam you're making, you're going to need a steam turbine. What was the one I made before? Gas turbine controller. So I can use any gas in that. See, I'm thinking I might do these quests at some point for some of the rewards, like semi-stable nuggets. Capacitor. Well, another the fact you need at least one in your generator. These will help buff up the amount of RF your generator can hold. So basic power capacitors. The qubit clusters are components for other machines and storage for RF. They come in five tiers. When you combine a tesseract with a large energy storage unit, you get the entangler. These are ways. Zero point extractor. This little guy can create RF from nothing. It seems to have something to do with the fabrics of space, so placing it towards the core of a planet seems to make it work better for some reason. Possibly best not to question science. This is advanced stuff that I don't think we're going to be able to do yet because of a lack of ender pearls. Okay, plan. I think gas is the way to go. But I'm going to be making gas using mine chem. So it is worth going down this way because I'm going to need turbines, inputs, fuel tanks, all of that I'm going to need, although I don't need the steam turbine because I don't think I'm going to make steam. We should be able to burn anything that's a gas. Well, anything that's a gas that can says it can burn in a turbine generator. So butene, C4H8, relatively simple. Burn time 1600. Propane, burn time 1400, C3H8. So slightly cheaper but a slower burn time. Okay. So this stuff is a liquid, not a gas. But it does say it can burn in a turbine generator for 180 RF per tick. But that's less than butane. Butane has a burn time of 1600, 272 RF per tick. 5700, 180 RF per tick. So this thing's less energy, but burns for a lot longer. But it's not a gas. So I think I'll try this stuff in the gas turbine generator. If it works, great, because it burns for so long. If it doesn't, I might switch my entire setup to making butane, because the butene should be able to burn fine in these things as well. So that's a lot to do. Hopefully some form of working gas generator by the end of the episode. So the chest is working again. See stuff flowing in and it's not ending up in there. The Mars cobblestone is, but that's because the Mars cobblestone barrel is completely full. I'll have to get a void upgrade on that. I finally made an RR pick. Why didn't anyone tell me that holding an RR pick gives you a speed boost? Look at the difference in speed. That's just walking. And then I go about twice as fast, and if I run, I really fly. If I get myself some sugar as well, then it's so fast I can barely control it. Anyway, stuff stuck in there, but that's because that's busy. Yeah, so this thing started working again on a world reload. Which is interesting. The other interesting thing is this is a new day. It's a new day. It's a new life. I'll stop singing now. This is a new day, and it took me 3 attempts to get into this world without it crashing. In the end, doing a forced update of the pack, you know, like a re-download, did get it working again, but this thing's a little unstable, which is rather worrying, because if this world corrupts and crashes and becomes unrecoverable, I'm not going to start again. I do take backups every, you know, before I start any play session, I make a backup of all the saves. So, I've not done that much. What I have done is prepare an area. I'm going to put an airlock here. So at the moment it's just bricked up, but I have prepared a room for the turbines and other power stuff we might be able to fit in as well. You know, like I might move the fuel generator and the Stirling generators and stuff like that into this room. So this is a nice, big, big room. So here's the gas turbine and rotors. This is stuff I was carrying when I made the golden bag of holding. Incidentally, with this RR pick, does anyone know, can it be repaired in an anvil? And if it can, what material do I use to repair it? Because It was a little expensive to make. Not hugely so. I mean, essentially, it's just a diamond pick, but I would still like to be able to repair it. It really is good, though. If you hold down shift and right click, it changes its digging mode. So a 3x3 will take out a 3x3 grid. And you can also go up to 5x5, which meant digging out the area for that room there was a lot easier. And then shift right-hand click again to go back to single block. I've learned the hard way. Make sure you always leave it in single block mode. Okay, so we are going to, let me make sure I call up a recipe for something random. There we go. Oh yeah, I was building at night and kept getting attacked by mobs, so I made myself a cryogenic chamber, which means I can sleep through the night now, which is cool. So we're going this way, down basically I think the turbine route. So the more you add to your multi-block, the more RF output per tick you'll receive, and of course the faster and faster fuel will burn. Right, so I need to make an iron turbine rotor, and it will give me a steel turbine upgrade kit. Yeah, so this was, those were five for four, so 11 iron. Right, I already had four of them. So steel turbine upgrade kit. And you actually have to just make a steel turbine. So there's no point making the iron turbines first and then upgrading them. A basic reward bag. That's pretty rubbish at this level. 128 limestone. Okay. So are these turbines something I can place in the world? Don't know. We'll find out. Now, all that rocket fuel, maybe we should use it for something. Okay, so I've got to make a fluid intake valve. This is how I get stuff into the gas turbine. It is a gas turbine I'm working on, isn't it? I mean, they asked me to make a gas turbine controller. Just iron. Probably got the stuff I need already. What's it called? Fluid intake valve. One fluid intake valve. It gets me a transfer node and a load of fluid conduit. That's Ender IO fluid conduit. Bottle-O enchanting. I've got 22 levels, and I've already got given another load of Bottle-O enchanting, so I'll go with the fluid conduits. Although they're quite easy to make, aren't they? It's just conduit binder, which is just gravel, sand, and clay. They're giving me these Bottle-O enchantings for a reason, but yeah, they already gave me some. Right, next, buffering. In case you wanted to increase the internal tank storage of your turbine, here you go, fuel tanks. Glass panes and iron frames. One fuel tank. I get a Bottle-O enchanting. Let's take the middle one. It's a greater reward bag this time. Spawn Paul. Got a lot of Pauls. I wonder if he can breed with himself. And last of all, steam usages, steam turbine controller. To use all the steam you're making, you're going to need a steam turbine, similar to the gas turbine. Well, I want to make a gas turbine. So, do I have enough now to get a working machine? Right, so put down the gas turbine controller. Fluid intake valve on top. Fuel tank. And then we have four iron turbine rotors. Machine is incomplete. It requires at least one turbine. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to put in. Is there a separate block called a turbine? Okay, so I need to make these things. Can be installed in a gas turbine controller or steam turbine controller. Produces 100 RF per tick. Steel turbine controller produces 200 RF per tick. Gold plated is at 150 RF per tick. Gold plated turbine, just put an iron turbine and a gold ingot. It's not bad, it's almost as good as steel. But steel is the best, so I'll aim for that. Vibrant turbine. Yeah, vibrant alloy is the stuff that requires ender pearls, so we'll have to hold off on that. Okay, so I need to make some iron turbines. Okay, so let's put the four of these down. Can I use my upgrade kit on one of them? Shift right click. Right, that's now a steel turbine. Iron turbines. Right hand click the controller. Hey, we've got a working thing. Okay, it's got four connected turbines, one steel, one iron. Peak production, it can do 500 RF per tick. It's not using any fuel. It has no current production. Has no current fuel consumption. Clear internal buffers. Output configuration. Different colors. Right. So, how can I get fuel in there? Now, for a start, we don't know whether or not this stuff will work even. Oh, I've got the iron turbine rotor back from when I did the upgrade. So I could make another iron turbine nice and easily. So we don't even know whether this stuff will work in here. Don't drink the methyl methacrylate. Ooh, that went in. And it did stuff. All right, let's just throw this stuff in there. Okay, so 7 buckets of methyl methacrylate, maximum 17 buckets. It's already got 100,000 RF in there, and it's not currently using it up. Okay, right, now we are getting somewhere. So I need like a power output. Looking at the gas turbine seemed to be the best way to learn how to use this thing. Gas turbine controller. Okay, so power emitters is presumably how I get power out. Then fuel air mixers and gas mix compressors probably increase its efficiency. Okay, now there was. So that's just a steam controller. Don't want that. This is making steam. I'm not going that route. And I'm not going syngas either. But I can go down this route, which adds a basic power capacitor to the generator. It means it can hold more. Like currently it's full of power at 100,000 RF. Power capacitors are in there. Okay. So let's make a basic power capacitor. Four basic capacitors and some frames. Right, one basic power capacitor. What was that? The capacity of 1,000,000 RF. Okay. So the basic machine has only 100,000. This will increase it by 10. Now it seems you can put these devices wherever you want. Obviously, the inputs and outputs will have to be on this front edge. I'll probably keep the controller somewhere near this for easy monitoring. But I can have these things stretching up, and even snaking round. So long as I think everything touches each other, it's not an issue. Yep. So this thing now has 1,100,000 RF. Okay, we can actually see it working now. Okay, fuel efficiency is 110%. It's using 2.6 millibuckets per tick. and it's producing 500 RF per tick. This thing is a lot more efficient than all these dudes. So, yeah, I think we're losing these. We're moving the fuel production into here. Does mean that this thing's always running out of carbon. I need to make. I think this thing needs its own tree farm, like a little tiny tree farm. That will just always be feeding into there. You know, like every time it chops down a tree, it could just be a single tree. It gets in there. Because the problem with just flowing the wood in is it just spends all its time decomposing the wood, and it never decomposes the next step. But maybe, you know, a small tree farm, just one by one or three by three, might be what we need. Right, that is it for this episode, I think. I've got stuff to work on. I mean, you know, now we know how this works. I can start put an airlock here, because I don't think that, you know, we need air in our gas turbine room. In fact, it's going to be safer without, because it means, you know, less chance of fire and explosions and stuff. So I'll move the fuel production in there. Reconfigure what we currently have. What is our current energy output? I'll ignore the ones with the capacitors. We were doing 20 RF per tick. So that's 9, 18, 36. We were doing 360 RF per tick with our current energy setup. And this thing already outstrips that at 500 RF per tick. And it's going to use the fuel, I think, a lot more efficiently, because this uses the fuel at 110% normal efficiency. These things, burn rate times two, these things have been using it at 50% efficiency. So, definitely the way to go. What else will I need to do? Move the fuel production in. Get its own little tree farm working. This thing's out of axes. And I think we will stick with this metal with this stuff, because a burn time of 5700, you know, at 180 RF per tick is way better than butene. So even with the more complex setup, it's better. You can see a single stack is giving us more than 8 stacks of carbon already. So a single tree growing away might be enough to keep everything running. Right. I will see you in the next episode, which hopefully will come out sooner than the gap we've had here. You know, 10, 12, it's what, 2 weeks since the last episode. I just got tired. It happens, unfortunately. Yeah, so things I want from you, if memory serves, and if I forget something and you remember it, then please tell me. 1, how can I repair my RR pick? 2, is there something more reliable than a sorting chest that I can easily use with this setup? Because, you know, I either need something where I can search for whatever I want, you know, like by typing it into a search box, or I need to be able to see the stuff in the barrels nicely, you know. So yeah, is there an alternative? Because that's unreliable. That's it, I think. That's all I was asking for. The Mars quarry is still digging away. Once that finishes off, we can go back to Mars with those ender markers we've now got and move the quarry. We'll work on the power. We'll work on fusion and fission, try and get an inexhaustible supply of enderpearls. Then we can think about going to other planets. Probably Venus. So I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.